Okay. Show me.
Hi there guys, welcome back to the Trusted Sheet channel. Thank you very much for tuning in for a review of the content of this box. Now, you've seen the title of the video, so this box contains an quadcopter or drone frame. And it's a frame kit, as you can see, you have to build it yourself. This frame is the Hyperlite Floss 3.0 racing frame. Well, I'm not sure if it's a racing frame, but it's a quadcopter frame for a 5-inch quad, 5-inch over here. I bought this quadcopter from a local store in the Netherlands, and obviously you can also buy it from Pyroflip. In case you are wondering, by the way, or in case you thought that this frame is designed by Kebab FEV or Bob, it is not. I'm not sure who designed this frame, but it's loosely inspired based on a design by Kebab FEV. And also, in this video, I'm not gonna fly this quadcopter yet. This video is part of a project, and I'll have a link up here to the entire playlist for this project. Maybe by the time you are watching this video, I have built a quadcopter and have flown it. And in that case, you can get an impression in one of the videos in this playlist. All right. So in this video, I'm gonna tell you what I think of the components delivered and the build quality and materials used. So, first of all, the box is pretty unassuming, as you can see. So none of your money went into the packaging and a nice design and such. Also, this is everything you get. And okay, so that leaves us without a manual. Do we need a manual? Probably not. Okay, and let's open this bag. Hachiki day. There's all the parts for our quadcopter. Now, the first thing I want to know is if all edges are chamfered. And they aren't. Yeah, they are. They have a light chamfer, if you will. So you don't. Yeah, they aren't. They won't cut you, if that's. And also, they are super duper clean. Okay, I was hoping obviously that it would be clean, but I've actually not come across many frames that are this clean. There is no dust on them at all. So that's great, of course. And in case you don't know, that dust that comes off of some of the frames you might order isn't healthy for you. So if your frame is dirty, please wipe it off with a damp cloth. Okay, a quick look at the parts we received. Now, you have probably already noticed that we received 5 arms, which is nice. So you get a spare arm. I didn't actually even know that, that's a bonus. And over here, we've got the base plate, if you will, of the quadcopter. Now, the arms will slot into grooves. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see the grooves, but there are distinct grooves over here in which the arms will sit. And you get the picture. Two arms like so, and these slots, these ridges, are meant to prevent the arms from moving around, right? Now, I have heard people complain about this fitment getting loose after a while. This is an aluminium plate, so not super duper hard, but for now, it feels nice and secure and it fits well. And after you fit all the arms into that base plate, like so, then you take this here base plate, carbon fiber base plate, screw it down like so, and we actually have the quadcopter upside down like this. Okay, it's not screwed down, of course, but... Okay, so this is what the quadcopter will fly like. This is the plate where you'd mount your flight stick to, for instance. And it actually looks nice as well. Okay, so you do get this aluminium plate and this this second carbon fiber base plate. You get this top deck, and obviously you get some risers to mount the top deck above your stack. Okay, what do we have here? These are the FV camera mounts, TPU printed parts. And we also get this FV antenna mount for the rear. Okay, we get, actually that's nice, I hadn't expected that, but a silicone mat for your battery. And we also get a battery strap, and it's not the most luxurious strap I've ever seen, to be honest. Is it actually... Yeah, it is a silicone covered strap, but I'll probably exchange it for another one with a metal buckle and maybe stitched and such, but it's nice to get a strap nonetheless, better than no strap. And maybe you can use this strap to mount your action camera. And the last thing in the bag were some screws and nuts to mount the thing together, which is what I'll do right now. So I'll build this frame off screen, and then I'll come back to you with my findings on this frame. So that took approximately 10 minutes or so, no more. So that was super duper easy. And it's a pretty basic frame as well, as you can tell. You already knew that, of course. You got four arms, a base plate and a brace at the bottom, four standoffs and a top plate, and that's basically the entire frame. And do you need a manual? No, you don't need a manual. You've got three types of screws. Shorter screws for the top plate over here. You've got longer screws for the for the arms, basically. And two other screws. And well, where can you go with those screws? Well, over here. Okay, so super duper simple. And does it feel... Yeah, it feels very stiff. Yeah, about how it feels, again, the sides of the carbon fiber are chamfered, maybe a lightly sanded. It feels very smooth, but it's not a huge transition, one you actually see in the video. Right, you don't see that the arms and the other frame components are in fact chamfered. Now, I have heard that some people cut their battery strap on this plate. So maybe I'll go and print something in TPU to protect the battery strap. Especially on these cutouts. Right, I can imagine ripping your battery strap apart on those. Even though it's not sharp or anything, but yeah. Okay, and now that we are looking at the bottom, as you can tell, you got these four cutouts, right? Also these four holes, and those are to enable you to reach the stack screws. So you don't need to take the frame apart to get to your stack screws. And that goes for the 30x30 stack or the 20x20 stack. Both are accessible. That's very, very nice. Also, in case you hadn't noticed, the stacks aren't connected to your arms, and that's less of an issue today, basically, with the vibration dampened stacks we see these days. But it should be should help in filtering out vibrations. Now let's have a quick look at the dimensions of this frame. Rear spacing is 13.5, front spacing is 13.5, so it's a symmetrical, it's not a hybrid. And front to back is 17 centimeters, and left rear to right front is 21.5 centimeters. And one more thing we need to know, and that's the weight of this frame. Let's have a looky. Okay, it's approximately 73.5, 74 grams, which is pretty light. To be honest, I will be having a look if I can find good frames that are even lighter than this one. I'm sure there are, and maybe I'll do that in a second lightweight quadcopter build. But it's in between hyper light, pun intended, and a heavy frame, right? So anything below 100 grams is reasonably light, of course, and it's well below 100 grams, but as you probably know, there are lighter frames available, and maybe I'll have a look if those are actually any good. If they are sturdy. I'm not a racer, I want to be able to crash a quadcopter and keep on flying, right? And that is my first look slash review of this Hyperlite 3.0 FPV quadcopter racing. It's called a racing frame. I'd say it's a general purpose frame. A full-on racer would have a smaller pod in most cases, less air resistance, but it leans towards a racing frame, that's true. One more thing, you could opt to run this quadcopter with the battery on top. Perfectly possible. I will probably be flying it with the battery at the bottom, but again, both are possible scenarios. Obviously, I will of course be flying this quadcopter as well. If you are looking at this video at a later date, I might already have a look on my channel. It's in the playlist of this build. So, and if you are left with questions, hit me up a comment down below. Catch you on the next video. Bye-bye.